How many halfway houses are on the chopping block? And if Governor LePage's budget passes as is, those residential treatment facilities say they will have no option but to shut their doors. The proposed cuts are so severe that a van pool has been organized for tomorrow so those affected by the cuts can state their case before a legislative hearing in Augusta. News 8's Jim Keithley is here now with the preview. Jim?
Tracy, the Maine Office of Substance Abuse delivered the bad news by letter recently. The Serenity House for Men, Crossroads for Women, and Day One for Youth Addicted to Drugs and Alcohol will all be affected if these cuts go through. Now, the people who run these programs and facilities say that the cuts, as proposed, would leave them no option but to close.
Meeting with fellowship a little bit. Hopefully some of that fellowship could find its way to Augusta.
Paul Dobby is an alcoholic who hit rock bottom 2 months ago. He's thankful he ended up here at the Serenity House.
It saved my life. Without this program, my life was going to be very short. I had two choices, get it right or die.
In 30 days, he'll leave here after intensive counseling, group sessions, and one-on-one meetings with his substance abuse counselor. He says this program allowed him to develop the skills and the confidence he needs to cope with life on the outside again.
Most of us come here with very little confidence, and that's been reinstilled.
This is a residential treatment facility that serves 150 men with drug and alcohol addiction each year. It's been serving the community for more than four decades. Its days, however, may be numbered if state budget cuts become reality.
The board of directors and I have sat around this table and we've discussed a couple of different options on what we would do. But what it always comes back to is, are there really enough dollars to do anything in such a short notice? And the answer is no. We would have to close our doors as a treatment facility starting July 1st.
Just down the road on Forest Avenue, Crossroads for Women. It's another program that will cease to exist if the governor's cuts are approved. Crossroads stands to lose $1 million of its $3 million budget. The program's clinical director says that will mean more vulnerable Mainers will end up on the streets.
It's a lot more dangerous sometimes for women out there. And, you know, women need a safe place to go. And we are the only program in the state that also serves women and children.
All of the players involved in these potential cuts say the short-term savings will only end up costing Mainers much more down the road.
If you took away this service, which is pennies on the dollar compared to somebody staying in a jail, somebody going to prison, or somebody going to the ER for the very fundamental human need of care, in the end, it would cost all of us taxpayers a lot more money.
Now, State Representative Ben Chipman is providing the van that will carry those clients from the Serenity House to the State House tomorrow to testify before the Appropriations Committee. The van will leave Serenity House at 8:30 in the morning. Public hearing begins at 10. Live in the studio, Jim Keithley, News 8.